reminded of two biblical characters in the Bible by the name of Joshua and Caleb. Joshua and Caleb were assigned to go and spy out the land called Canaan. 10 other men went with Joshua and Caleb that were on the same assignment. Keep in mind, Joshua and Caleb and the 10 individuals that all went together to spy out the land in Canaan were all assigned by Moses. Well, when they got over to spy out the land in Canaan, they believed that the land was theirs. They believed that the land was flowing with milk and honey. And the land was truly flowing with milk and honey. The land was fruitful. However, the land was also occupied. Well, what happened and what occurred once they got over in the land of Canaan, the 10 men that went with Joshua and Caleb found themselves being very fearful. Fear had set in because of the size of the people that dwelt in the land of Canaan. They said to themselves, they said, wow, they're like giants, and we're like grasshoppers. What happened was, after they had evaluated the land, Joshua, Caleb, and the other 10 men that went with Joshua and Caleb came back unto their own company. When they got back with their own company, they said amongst themselves, the 10 men said to the congregation, that this land that we went to occupy, this land that we feel that ours, this land is not fruitful. Fear had set in, and when fear set in, it brings about doubt. They said that this land is not fruitful. This land is also occupied. They caused a great disturbance in the whole community. They said, this land, we cannot overcome it simply because of the people that's there are much larger than there. But Joshua and Caleb stilled the people. When Joshua and Caleb stilled the 10 individuals that went, they said, wait a minute. Joshua and Caleb said, we are well able to overcome the land. We are well able to possess the land. We are well able to succeed in the land. Although it's a little bit challenging, they said within themselves, speaking of Joshua and Caleb, that we are confident that we can possess the land. Well, what happened was fear set in. And when fear set in, it brings about negativity and all the above. Good afternoon. My name is Rodney Mills, and I'm here to help you and to bring a reassurance of you and to help you to gain confidence of moving forward in efforts of conquering your fears. Well, when we look at fear, we want to look at some things here on this afternoon concerning fear. We need to make sure that we surround ourselves with positive people. Because if we surround ourselves with negative people, we'll find ourselves dealing with bad influence. Well, let's look at influence. Influence is someone or a group of people or even individuals having the ability to persuade or affect the decisions or events of others. Let me give you an example. In other words, if you were with a group of people and you was getting ready to purchase some land, if that would be the case, and everybody was for the land, but all of a sudden now you have 3 or 4 or 5 people standing up and they're saying, well, if you get the land, how you gonna pay the money back? Suppose you lose your job. And if you lose your job, do you have a plan B? And all the time, it always seems that negative outweigh positive. But guess what? You gotta have enough faith and believe in yourself. And you gotta believe, because from the biblical side of it, we have to look at the Bible declared that greater is he that's within us than he that's within the world. So you have to believe in yourself. So guess what? In order to conquer your fears, we find here that you gotta have faith. What is faith? Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. You gotta have enough faith. And once you get faith, guess what? You're gonna have power. Once you get power, you're gonna have strength. Once you get strength, you're gonna have confidence. Once you get confidence, you're gonna have courage. Once you get courage, guess what? You're also gonna have boldness to face your fears and to also conquer your fears. Well, let's look at our board here. What is fear? Fear is anxiety caused by approaching danger. I'm going to say that again. Fear is anxiety caused by approaching danger. In other words, fear is anxiety caused by approaching danger. That word approaching. In other words, sometimes we get fearful of what we think is going to happen before it even happened. Fear is anxiety caused by approaching danger. It has not even happened. Guess what? If it's the mail, we have not even opened the mail. We just seen the letter. Fear is caused by approaching danger. Anxiety caused by approaching danger. So we have to learn to conquer our fears with our faith. Well, what is anxiety? Anxiety is an agitated spirit produced by imaginary fears. In other words, if you think negative long enough, you will begin to believe the negative side versus the positive side. Anxiety is an agitated spirit produced by imaginary fear. It's that little guy that's in your mind that's negative, that's saying, no, it's not going to work out. No, you can't do it. And if you do it, will it last? And if you do it and if you fail, everybody's going to talk about you. But you have to have, again, enough faith within yourself. Enough faith within yourself to conquer your fears. You have to have enough faith within yourself to conquer your fears. Well, faith without works is dead. So you have to apply your faith to your daily situations, your daily circumstances. Guess what? To your success. We were created to deal with challenges. So we must understand that anxiety is an agitated spirit produced by imaginary fears. But you can conquer that through your faith. Well, let's look at imagination. Imagination is ability to imagine things that aren't real. There are a lot of people in life that can imagine what's going to happen. It goes back up to fear. We're imagining what might happen. Having the ability to imagine things that aren't real. Well, guess what? The flip side of that, take your imagination from the positive perspective and think about the positive things that can happen. Being successful, conquering your fears, reaching your goals in life. So we must understand that we must have faith in order to conquer our fears. As I first stated when we first opened up this presentation, there were 12 individuals that went to spy out the land. Well, with 12 individuals that went to spy out the land, there were two reports that came back. How can you have two reports that come back to the same company, two negative reports, one negative and one positive report? That's simply because when people are fearful, they will try to convince others to be fearful also, simply because they're scared of challenges. Joshua and Caleb said that the land was flowing with milk and honey. Not only was the land flowing with milk and honey, but the land was also very fruitful. They said, yet the land was occupied. But again, I say it to you, we were created for challenges. Life is not even fun without going through challenges. They said to themselves, they said the land is occupied. But wait a minute. Caleb stilled the people and Caleb said this. Caleb said, we are well able. Caleb had that confidence. We are well able. And that's what you will have to say to yourself. When you find yourself coming up against challenges, say to yourself, I'm well able to overcome this. I'm well able to conquer this. I'm well able to reach my goals. I'm well able to be successful. But then if you hang around negative people, you'll find yourself dealing with the 10 men that came back that had a negative report. And guess what they said? They lied and said that the land was not fruitful. They brought back an evil report and said the land was unfruitful. They brought back an evil report and said that the people in the land were like giants and we were like grasshoppers. However, they brought back such a negative report, they disturbed the whole company. And when they disturbed the whole company, people began to get disappointed. But guess what? Joshua and Caleb had enough confidence within themselves, regardless of all the negativity, regardless of all the negative talk. Joshua and Caleb had enough confidence within themselves, watch this, to conquer all of their fears. And what I want share with you today in my closing is to share with you, regardless of what you have to face, regardless of how big it is, regardless of how small it is, regardless of how wide it is, regardless of how tall it is, you have enough faith within yourself simply because, from a biblical perspective, we have all been dealt the measure of faith. And you have enough faith within yourself to conquer your fears. So what will I leave with you today? Go after it. Conquer it. Reach your goals. Be successful. Regardless of whatever you have to face that's very challenging, life is not even fun without challenges. You can do it. I believe in you. Believe in yourself. Take care now.